that's a good analogy if you think that the cream is America, and the cream being the best of the best is the people that are going to get the money. So I guess the whipper could be what you have to do to be the best, is you have to get your ass beat every day, going to work, going to four jobs, and going to school, and raising children without Social Security or any kind of help from the state. Maybe. That's just my idea. That's our idea of whip it good. Whip the cream, and you'll get the best. Let's go. I mean, in my opinion, the original American dream was, it was pure and it was beautiful. And I think if we can go back to that one day, where everyone, not only just in America, but in the world, has a right to be more and have more than what they are, not just for money. I moved to Paris about 5 years ago, and it was good for me. And I think that I feel like here I'm living my American dream. In fact, I have friends in California. I have a really good friend, two really good friends actually. And you can go and stay there if you want and ask people, look around and talk to people, see what they say.
Voilà, on est dimanche matin. Ici, c'est le marché de Hollywood. C'est plutôt des légumes, des fruits bio. Ça se passe tous les dimanches. Ce sont les riches, les pauvres qui se rencontrent. C'est un peu le melting pot des États-Unis. C'est sympa, c'est deux rues qui sont fermées. De 9h jusqu'à 1h de l'après-midi. Et on va faire les courses, on va bien manger. Les fruits, les légumes dans les supermarchés, c'est pas très, ils ne sont pas très bons aux États-Unis. Ils ont une jolie couleur, ils ont une belle forme, mais le goût n'est pas là. Mais ici, on trouve des choses qui sont bien. Et de plus, c'est agréable de parler avec des gens, aller à pied, on n'a pas besoin de voiture. Il y a de la musique. Agréable de discuter avec les gens qui viennent d'autres parties de Californie ou du monde. I'll take one chicken and cheese and one squash mushroom and cheese.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
How are you?
Yes, gracias.
Okay.
¿Cómo está?
Muy bien.
Yeah, excelente. Gracias, güey.
Mi nombre es Delmi. Mis pupusas favoritas, muy ricas. No son las primeras, pero sí las mejores. Las number one, the pupusas number one. That's very good. Chicken and cheese, pork and cheese, beef. La pupusa es tradición de El Salvador. muy rica. Como puedes ver, ¿a ti te gusta mucho? El negocio, 18 años, 18 years. Muchos.
¿Te gusta?
Sí, me encanta. Amo California. Sí. Amo mi gente, mis clientes, everything. Everything is nice.
Do you have a store also or a restaurant?
Right now, no. I have only farmer market. Maybe this year, este año, me agarraré un restaurante aquí en Hollywood.
Oh, yes. I go and see a los franceses.
Que los quiero mucho, que vengan aquí a comer pupusas y que están bien sabrosas y los voy a atender yo siempre, porque todos los amo mucho. Abrazos, besos para todos.
Le marché va bientôt être fini, ça commence à fermer, mais on peut se retrouver demain avec mes élèves à Manual Arts High School. C'est un lycée qui est dans le ghetto, c'est aussi le plus vieux lycée qui a toujours des élèves à Los Angeles. Et avec une population d'élèves assez diverse, des Africains-Américains, des Salvadoriens, des Mexicains, des Nicaraguenses, Guatemaltais. Et ça peut être assez intéressant de leur en parler, de votre rêve américain.
Je fais partie de la résistance, de la guerre contre le monde qu'ils ont lancée ici, aux States. Et on dit que n'importe quelle raison qu'ils disent, le gouvernement, l'administration des États-Unis, cette guerre contre le peuple d'Irak, c'est pas légitime, c'est pas juste. C'est contre de toutes les morales. En fait, ça c'est un crime atroce.
L'American Dream existe-t-il encore?
Le cauchemar. Oui, en fait, maintenant, on dit que... Je sais pas ça. Qu'est-ce que c'est ça, le rêve américain?
Des Mexicains qui viennent ici, pour eux, c'est un rêve.
Les Mexicains viennent ici parce que les États-Unis ont détruit ce pays, son économie. En fait, ils viennent ici pour dar la bouffe à ses familles. Alors, ce n'est pas parce qu'ils aiment McDo, c'est parce qu'ils veulent bouffer. Simplement, ils aiment leur pays. Les Mexicains aiment vraiment leur pays.
Mais pourquoi est-ce que les Américains ont peur de témoigner quand ils sont pas en accord avec le gouvernement? On sent qu'il y a une vraie angoisse.
Les Américains qui ont peur de parler contre l'administration.
J'ai rencontré des GI et autres qui sont tout à fait en désaccord avec la guerre, qui sont contre Bush en ce moment.
Moi aussi j'ai peur, mais qu'est-ce qu'on peut faire?
Mais qu'est-ce qui fait si peur?
On a plus de droits. On n'a plus de droits. On avait les droits, on dit. Mais en fait, on voit maintenant qu'ils peuvent écraser ces droits sans problème pour eux, sans problème. Alors, mais qu'est-ce qu'on peut faire? Moi aussi, j'ai peur, mais qu'est-ce qu'on peut faire?
Mais donc, le pays des libertés...
Le pays de dollars. C'est le pays de dollars. C'est le pays de... Qu'est-ce qu'on dit? Les profits. Comme la France, en fait, pays impérialiste.
Oh. American dream is to stay the same, never change, walk around, just do what is given to me to do. Stay real, stay the same. My American dream is to make it to heaven. And my American dream is to make people like my music. I'm gonna give you a little taste. Because what I did earlier wasn't even a little taste.
Costume for my next show, because I have an acting place on Seventh Heaven, and I have to go buy a costume. You want to come with me? You can come with me, and let me show you my costume that I have to buy. That coming here in the United States, money grows on trees. It does not grow on trees. You have to work really hard. You have to do a lot of things to survive. Plus, you get paid minimum wage. Because once you're legal, nobody wants to take you and work with them. Plus, you have to learn the language, or either you won't communicate at all. You have to ask around people. And it's very difficult. People who come here, they think coming here, everything's easy, but it's not easy. There's a lot of teenage pregnancies. There's a lot of disease, a lot of racism, especially in our community, drug dealing, killings. And domestic violence, a lot of violence and partners. It's straight, gay, it don't matter. You still get in trouble here. And you have to survive to make a living. And a lot of people take advantage of you. So it's really hard. And plus, you're illegal. I'm pretty sure a lot of illegal people feel the same way. Because INS will take you in and will throw you back to the country. And then you have to come back, and that's a hassle. Just crossing the border is a hassle. I'm talking about my own experience. I don't know what else to say, seriously. And my hair got a nut.
Oops.
We change our names constantly. Why? We want to be the white people, you know. Even what? Though your name could be Maria, then you suddenly you're Jones, you know, you're Smith. Okay, you guys remember the costume that I bought on Hollywood? I'm gonna put this and gonna wear it. This is the American flag, as you can see. But no, I'm gonna let you see. So I'll see you guys soon. I just wrote it last night, so. If there are any mistakes, I'm sorry.
I am Geronimo's daughter. He was famous to the world. I survived the big genocide that was made in the name of liberty. When the white people came here, they saw the gold in the mountains. They were dreaming of freedom, just like anybody else. But unfortunately, they were raped and killed. Nothing has really changed. Nothing at all. Rich white people were exploiting poor people so that dreams can come true.
Now, my people, listen to this, people, live in camps. Black people live on the projects and the ghettos. Latinos are getting paid under wage jobs. American person asks for a raise every 6 months. They're not gonna work for a minimum wage job. What American dream? Would you like to live an American dream?
Why don't you go to Las Vegas?
Think about it, Las Vegas. Where all the money there is. But just remember, the house always wins.
American dream, an American dream, I could be your worst nightmare.
And Miss Enzer, would you please call the main office?
I just want to get the computers, I'm doing grades and stuff. Okay.
Yeah. For days,
please.
Si vous voulez. It's what you consider, you know, yourself to be. We don't care exactly what you say. Right? D'origine. Because that, I've let you, you know, I've said Mexican American, because that's what we do in the United States. I didn't really know how they put it. They would just normally say, if you hold on to your parents, then you just say, like you say, je suis Salvadorian. Mais j'habite aux États-Unis. We're not going to check your passports.
Okay.
Alors, moi, je m'appelle Monsieur Mulligan. Je suis le professeur de français ici à Manual Arts High School. Ça, c'est les élèves qui apprennent le français depuis 3 ans. Et Amy, c'est sa deuxième année de français. Mais elle est très, très, très douée. Elle s'intéresse beaucoup à la langue. Elle pense peut-être qu'elle aimerait bien être professeur de français plus tard.
J'ai 17 ans. J'aime le français.
Je m'appelle James. Je suis 17.
Je m'appelle Kiana. Je suis 17. Je suis 17. Yeah, just 17. No, just 8 ans.
Je suis Salvadorien. Je voudrais être un avocat. Et j'ai 17 ans.
Une avocate comme Ally McBeal?
Yeah. Oui.
Vous travaillez pour la ville de Los Angeles?
For the...
Est-ce que tu veux travailler avec la police?
Non?
Est-ce que tu as un exemple de ce que la police fait qui n'est pas bon?
Like, they have killed like more than 13 people so far.
Ah oui, ça c'était, oui, il y a 2 semaines, 3 semaines. Et nous avons perdu 2 élèves. La police a pensé que les 2 élèves avaient volé la voiture. Ce qui n'était pas le cas. Nous avons un problème de violence avec la police à Los Angeles.
Qu'est-ce qui vous intéresse dans la culture française?
Je suis intéressé dans la culture française parce que beaucoup de personnes ne connaissent pas la culture française.
I didn't like the cheese, French cheese. Then when I eat it, then when I taste it, now I like it. So you just have to try different things to see if you really like it.
I want to know more about other cultures. And I don't want to be ignorant to other people's cultures.
Mais est-ce que tu penses en général que les Américains connaissent les cultures qui ne sont pas américaines?
Mm-mm.
Et pourquoi est-ce que les Américains ne connaissent pas les autres cultures?
I think because they don't really want to learn about other people's heritage and culture and everything. Because they have the power right now, so what would be the point?
Qu'est-ce que tu penses à propos de ce que Marthe vient de dire?
Like when the whole 9/11 thing happened, a lot of people started... started judging all Arabs. They started judging all Arabs, so they made a big generalization about all Arabs that they're terrorists and they were harassing the Arabs. So I think by learning other people's cultures, we'll all get along better.
Is liberty for all people?
I think it should be for our people, but that's not how it works here, because liberty is only granted to American citizens, not residents or immigrants who barely come into the country. Because you have to earn your liberty by becoming a citizen.
Liberty is like, it's kind of a privilege, but it's also like you can buy liberty sometimes. We're like one of the most freest countries here in the world. But I wouldn't call it really freedom. It's like how you have a dog that lives with you, and you have some people that have a dog and they tie it to a chain. He's not free. But you have some people who have a dog and they let it loose on the chain, but it can't leave the fence. So we're kind of like the dog in a fence who's free to walk around the inside the fence, but not able to go out the fence as it please. So that's how our freedom here is.
Voilà, on s'est retrouvés et on va faire la fête. A big party.
Hey, it's Diego again. Here we are, and we're actually very excited. So we are deciding that we are going to sing the Acereje song right here. So it goes. Acereje, ha, deje, deje, bedu, deje, bedu, save you, no, ba, mahali, and the boogie, deep, deep. Let's go.
Living the American dream, is it possible? You know, I remember exactly when I came from Mexico and I decided with my family that we needed a better life. We weren't able to eat anymore, we weren't able to work anymore. We wanted to be happy. All we needed to do was have some education and a way of living. I told you it was tough leaving our country because your heart belongs to it. But we had to say goodbye to our country and to each and every single family member. The hard part was coming to the United States, learning a new language, then trying to make a living, illegally get a job and hurt and get to know people. The American dream is possible. It happened for me when I saw my family actually grow up, get a home, have cars, give me an education. And then my American dream is just growing and growing every day. My biggest dream is to become a superstar. Now I am a superstar. I'm as international as I want to be. Yes, if you believe in God and you are healthy and you are happy, the American dream can happen to you. It can happen to anybody. I just want to wish you the best of luck to you and every single person around you today and every day. God bless you, and my heart from Diego goes to you. The American dream can come true.
I'm free.
I'm free.
I'm free.
I'm free.
I'm free.
Thank you. We're leaving. All right, we're leaving. We're leaving. She says, stop beating the drum. She says, stop beating the drum. Even then.
Okay, it's not all right for them.
Well, you know how they do. They have nothing. They have
another big deal.
Nothing better to
do. Oh, no,
only in America.
Only in America.
Right.
Can you say that one more time?
Only in America.
Again.
Only in
America. What about
only
in America?
One more time.
Only in America. Only in America.
Why cannot be me?
Here, can I play a guitar?
No, we got the police. No, the police want to see.
Okay.
Oh, see the point of the light.
That's why I say only in America. Yeah.
And you know what?
They're a very great band. Like, this is bullshit. I live in this city. I don't care. I'm very upset with this.
They don't respect artists.
Yeah.
Things that are positive. They want things that are negative. To pretty much keep people depressed. You know, keep you depressed. So that means they figure if they can keep people depressed, that's means of controlling them. You know. It doesn't realize what it's actually doing is making the country weaker. It's like common sense, it's not common anymore. You know. When they see black people, black Americans like myself, they want us to see us negative. But when they see us positive, it destroys them. Because
why should it destroy them?
Because they think negative about the positive energy that's within us. And I guess I don't know if it's because instead of uniting, it's very complicated to me, but I know they would rather see me doing something negative than positive. To see me doing something positive is like a computer that breaks down. They can't comprehend it in their mind. They can't conceive it. Everybody's the same. There's no difference. We all speak the same language from the heart, which is love.
Right.
And music. Music is the movement of life. Also, music changes things. You know? And all of a sudden, I heard someone says, can I talk to you? I thought someone was giving me a movie or a contract or something. But it was the police. He says, you have to move farther down. You're too close to the machines. He says, you out here hanging out. I says, hanging out? Sir, I'm playing music. He says, well, you're just out here hanging out. And I want to give you a ticket just because you're out here. I said, sir, you have nothing better to do? I said, there's terrorists. You have people out here dealing with drugs and doing negative things. I'm doing something very positive. I said, probably you don't, there's a reason why you don't know who the terrorism is, because you guys are terrorizing everyone. You know? But basically, what am I doing wrong? Well, it's just the fact that you're hanging out. You're lottering. It's called lottery. I said, sir, I don't want to get insulted, but I am playing music. So anyway, I left. I eventually went to court. He threw it out.
Ain't got no money. Ain't got no car. Ain't got nobody. I won't go far. How's my baby? How's her now? Just got my guitar.
So, tell me.
Yeah.
According to you, is there an American dream or not?
Anything's possible if you put your mind to it.
Everything's possible in this country?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Just gotta put your mind to it instead of set your mind to it.
Yeah?
Hey, I'm playing, I was here. Does the American dream exist? Is there an American dream?
It does if you make it exist.
Yeah?
Yeah, this is a place where anything can happen, but you have to make it happen. Well, there are a lot of major things wrong with America, but you can't use that as an excuse. There are opportunities here. You have to sort of bypass the obstacles, which are hard. There's a lot of what you call mental slavery here. I'm going to have to go now. My name is DJ Ross David I. Local DJ, and it's nice to talk to you. Bye-bye.
Pour moi, il n'existe pas l'American Dream. Pour moi, c'est une opportunité qui est ouverte aux gens les plus brillants, les plus motivés, les plus indépendants, les plus forts. Il faut être très fort pour avoir accès à l'American Dream. Si on considère sa vie sur un horizon d'un an, deux ans, trois ans, effectivement, beaucoup de choses sont possibles. Mais à long terme, on peut toujours perdre son travail, on n'a pas d'allocation chômage, on n'a pas de sécurité sociale et encore moins de retraite. Donc effectivement, je trouve ça assez terrifiant. J'ai toujours entendu dire, en fait, les Américains sont géniaux parce que pour eux, parler d'argent, c'est pas un problème. Je trouve que c'est une idée complètement absurde parce qu'ici, on ne parle que d'argent et on vous considère en fonction de votre revenu, de votre succès. Et il y a un stress, je crois, énorme, vraiment un stress énorme sur la réussite et la compétition. Pour être Américain, il faut avoir cet esprit-là, je crois. Je pense qu'on est dans une période d'étouffement social qui pourrait effectivement se comparer au macartisme. En privé, on va te dire que le système est mal fait, mais en public, les gens restent quand même dans une sorte de conformisme social où tout va bien. Les gens hésitent beaucoup à en parler parce qu'ils ont peur du gouvernement fédéral. Et c'est vrai que la police fédérale et la Maison Blanche sont très, 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 très durs avec les dissidents. Quand ils arrivent à les coincer, c'est fini pour eux. Quand on utilise l'expression « le rêve américain », j'ai l'impression que c'est une conception un peu hollywoodienne de la vie américaine. Je trouve que les Américains, s'ils sont forts sur quelque chose, c'est sur l'embellissement de la réalité. L'American Dream, on le voit dans les films, on le voit dans les romans, on le voit chez les personnes les plus riches, chez Bill Gates. L'American Dream, c'est une mise en scène de ce qu'il y a de meilleur ici.
My name is René. I came here when I was 19.
Where are you from?
Actually, I'm from El Salvador. That's Central America.
Margaritas, beers, wine.
Being in this country, you know, you have to learn English. You know, like that, you have open doors anywhere. And it's going to give you a lot of opportunities being bilingual. People who doesn't, you know, probably have 20, 25 years, 30 years here and they don't speak anything. And they just have a really, would say, poor job. You know, they don't really grow because they cannot speak the language.
I think there's only one stage.
Yeah, but this,
you have a leaf
on
this.
They're going to think this is how Americans eat, paper plates. Back in France, they're gonna say, oh,
I mean, just enjoying doing whatever I'm doing right now, you know. And, but still, I want to become, you know, be bigger than what I am right now. You know, become a manager, you know. Actually, I'm a manager, but, you know, I just want to have the title, you know.
Oh my God, is this hot? Let's see. Remember, I'm the one who introduced you, so you've been nice to me. He's old enough.
Did you get that?
All my dream was just to come to this country, you know. I was all the time, you know, dreaming about to come and, you know, see how was United States.
And then you want to go.
The French though, every night is a dinner party, yeah. Like, pretty much.
Or are you drinking the other?
Every night you have your appetizer, you have your dinner, you have your salad, your cheese. Like, that's almost every night.
Yeah. And it's very common that you say, well, we're going to invite someone over for dinner. You know, and we don't do that here.
Yeah. Being legal, you know, it's like opening every door here in this country. And when that is open, you just have to be careful and accept whatever life is giving you.
It's got like, I don't know, I think I got about 40 pages.
Wow, that's a big one.
Yeah, but it's like a book.
Mm-hmm. The one can go on your website
and,
send you some new things.
Yeah,
and,
yeah,
that's good.
Update links and stuff like that. Pictures and pictures that I can put up, you know, whatever.
I know that. You want two? Maybe one.
Okay.
That's what I do over here. I can do you two for 12. This guy's not filming me.
Oh, he's doing a documentary.
Come on, film.
Look out, you're gonna get shot.
Yeah.
My name's Marvin Mina. I'm 29 years old. I'm an American, but I was born in the Philippines. My parents emigrated here back when I was a little boy. I grew up not in this area, but not too far in the next city over, Glendale. And I work as I'm a physician, I'm a doctor. My specialty is family medicine, and so I like to do it all. I'm probably gonna do a subspecialty in obstetrics, so, because I like delivering babies, so.
but this is, I'm renting a house out here. This is Pasadena, San Marino, Pasadena area. And I live here with two roommates. They're also doctors. One is a pediatrician, and the other is also a family doctor like me. And we're renting a nice house out here. It's fun. We have great neighbors. I was telling a friend earlier that if I didn't become a doctor, I probably would have been a chef. I would love to study to be a chef. The good thing about living in America is that you can do both. You know, they have professional schools, and sometimes it takes a little money, but even then, you can get help from the government, and you'll get scholarships and loans and all sorts of things. Don't get me wrong, I like being a doctor. I love it. I think it's the best job in the world. It's so rewarding and so fantastic to see. But, sometimes it's nice. I haven't cut the chicken. Oops. Now, I work a lot, so I don't get to cook as often as I would like to, but it's still, it's a nice way to relax. It's a good way to spend your time and relax a little bit. One of the things about living in America is we're often defined by our job. So I am Marvin the doctor. I'm Marvin the doctor that likes to cook, which is a different thing. But, that's okay. When I was overseas, I did a rotation while I was in medical school in Argentina, and what I was finding is that the impression of what an American is over there is, they're white, they're from the Midwest, they talk like I do, the same accent, but they eat hamburgers and French fries and watch MTV all day long. And there are some Americans like that out here. What I was finding by spending time in another country like that is that it's important for me to define myself as an American, because then it shows the rest of the world, Americans don't just look like George Bush and his daughters. Some of them look like me. We sound the same, we have the same culture. Probably unlike other countries in the world, physicians in America make a good living. They make a reasonable salary. No one's going to be a millionaire. Some physicians are, but paid very well. Most doctors in America are paid very well. And so we were lucky that my mother had studied that, and so she was able to provide for us. We were sent to private school, going to school, and learning a trade or learning a profession is key to success. Being well educated in general is important. And so, in that sense, my family has a very typical American dream story. Although it wasn't their intention originally to come here, they understand that there's opportunity here that they can take advantage of. And I was very lucky. I was able to have a very good education. And, 29 years old, I'm a doctor. That's not that bad. It's pretty good. Although secretly, if I wasn't doing this, like I said, I'd probably be a chef. And there's no, I can still go to cooking school. In between surgeries, sure, that's no problem, but anyway. So, second batch of chicken. So that's that. I think it's better. This is the last thing what we're gonna do now is make the lumpia. The lumpia is the Filipino answer to egg rolls. So this is something that I made about a month ago, and the beauty about this is it keeps in the freezer, so it's wonderful. It is the last thing we're doing because the guests are about 15 minutes from arriving. I'm just going to change my shirt and everything will be crispy. So as you can see, we've got the chicken, we have some fresh apples, some salad, the adobo is almost done, the guests are arriving, there's a few in the living room already, so hopefully you can join us for dinner. If not, have a good time. Au revoir.
Nothing wrong with the American dream to a certain extent.
everybody wants to live comfortably. Everybody wants to be healthy. Everybody wants to have a life that is less stress, less worries, to be able to do things that you want to do. And that doesn't just exist in America, that just exists all over the world. Life could be easier and could be richer, but it's, it shouldn't be the end product. It shouldn't be to have a bigger house, a bigger car, or a nicer washing machine and continue that way. At some point, I hope, where enough people around the world are healthy and content and satisfied with their lives, that they can focus their dreams on something a little bit more philosophical, or a little bit more intellectual, or a little bit more cultural, so that the exchange of ideas, so that not only are our bodies taken care of with nice clothes and nice cars and nice houses, but our minds are taken care of, our minds are enriched, and we can learn about other people, we can learn about new things, and we can become better people, not just richer people.
Face to face.